The longleaf pine has been a part of our culture for many centuries. It's a very important species to our people. We would use the trees to make our cabins. We would use the needles to make our baskets. So, you know, it's very important that we move that tradition down, because once we lose that information, we lose part of our culture. And the same thing happens to the species. If we lose that species, it's no longer part of our culture. When you see a basket and you open it up, you look in there, there's nothing in there except you can see the weaving. But it's not empty. The basket is full of love. It's full of happiness. It's important to have those thoughts. Let's be thankful for the Creator giving these longleaf pine trees to be able to continue with this legacy.
Longleaf pine is the historic tree of the South, from Florida to East Texas, and then up into the Carolinas. What once was 90 million acres was logged out, and by the early 1900s was virtually lost from the landscape. I mean, looking at 98% loss of this species. And I call it the tree that fire built. Without fire, you don't have longleaf. Fire suppression, or removing fire from the landscape, has attributed to the loss of this habitat that needs fire to exist.
For our people, we use fire as a tool to clear the brush, keep trails open, trade routes open. We use it as a hunting technique. We used it to keep the woods healthy, just maintain a healthy ecosystem in the area where you're living. Taking a lot of that, applying it to what we're doing today, we want to make sure that these longleaf pines are stimulated, make sure they have some good growth. I personally wanted to bring this resource back to the tribe, make it readily accessible, and then take advantage of, you know, the longleaf that is here.
The partnership with the Alabama-Coushatta, we really partnered to get fire on the landscape together. You can't do this work alone, so you're going to need all the players and all the partners to ultimately put more acres in longleaf here in Southeast Texas.
With the Nature Conservancy and the Alabama-Coushatta Tribe, when you look at their goals, what's beneficial for them, and you meld it together, it makes a beautiful story. If enough people care about anything, they can make wonderful things happen, and that's happening with the longleaf restoration efforts.
We have this valuable resource right here. You know, this is the woods that we grew up in. To know that I could use my talents, my skills to improve our lands, it really means a lot to me to have this resource for the benefit of the tribe.
People don't normally think of a tree as a threatened species. Usually folks are thinking of a snake or a bird. This species having 3% or so remaining of what once was, yeah, just as important to bring back in the system for generations to see and experience. The Nature Conservancy owns and manages almost 6,000 acres of longleaf pine at the Roy E. Larson Sandyland Sanctuary in Silsby, Texas. I've worked here for 15 years, so this is really not only my job, but really my lifestyle. This is kind of my backyard. I've done this work and seen these management units change and improve over time. Longleaf is my life, for sure. This is the native landscape. This is truly what East Texas is supposed to look like out here.
In our culture, a lot of our history is passed down orally. A great deal of it wasn't written down anywhere. And for us, it was our elders and our family. It was their way of teaching us why things are the way they are.
without her teaching and her passing it on to us, the culture wouldn't be where it's at today.
The weaving is all right here. Everything that goes on in your hand, it goes in here. You wrap it up.
We face a crisis when we lose an elder because there's stories and history that is no longer available. We wouldn't know how to use a longleaf if that information was never brought down to us.
When you're talking about longleaf pine, of course you're talking about revitalizing that species to still be here for future generations. You want them to have the same strength in our customs, our traditions that our previous generations, our ancestors had.